solve the equations z square minus 5 plus I into z plus 8 plus I equal to 0. This is the quadratic equations z square minus 5 plus I into z plus 8 plus I equal to 0. This is the quadratic equation. Quadratic equation az square plus bz plus c is equal to 0. That means here a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 5 plus I. Z coefficient is known as the b. But original equation have the positive sign, so negative consider here. B is equal to minus 5 plus I. C is equal to 8 plus I. The quadratic equation is solved by the delta method. So first of all, we have to find the delta. Delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. B here minus 5 plus I whole square, 4 into the value of a is equal to 1, c is equal to 8 plus I. Remove the bracket. Minus 5 plus I whole square, that is 5 plus I whole square. 4 taking in inside, that is 32 plus 4i. A plus b whole square. The formula of a plus b whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Here a is equal to 5 and b is equal to I. We get 5 square plus 2 into 8, that is 5, b is equal to I plus b whole square, that is I whole square minus 32. Negative side taking inside, that is minus 32 plus minus become minus 4i. 5 square is 25, 2 5 is 10, 10i, I square. The value of I square in complex number we discuss about I square is equal to minus 1. I square is equal to minus 1, minus 32, minus 4i. Now we have to add the real number. 25 minus 1, that is 24. 24 minus 32, that is minus 8. 10i. Combine imaginary part, 10i minus 4i. 10i minus 4i, that is 6i. So this is the delta. Now we have to find the value of delta in square form. So we can't directly find the square root of minus 8 plus 6i. So this term convert into complete square. This term convert into complete square, we have to find out the modulus delta. So this is considered as again x and y. Modulus delta, the modulus formula is square root of x square plus y square. So square root of x square plus y square minus 8 whole square 6 whole square is equal to minus 8 whole square, that is 64, 6 whole square, that is 36, and square root addition is 100. Square root of 100 answer is 10. So we get answer modulus 10 is equal to modulus delta is equal to 10. Now we have to find the square root of delta. So we have standard formula, square root of delta is equal to square root of modulus delta plus x by 2 plus I into sine of y square root of modulus delta minus x by 2. This is the standard formula. We get modulus delta is equal to 10, x is equal to minus 8 by 2 plus sine of y. So here sine of y is equal to positive. So as it is, modulus delta is equal to 10, x is equal to 2 by 2. So 10 minus 8, that is 2, 2 to cancel, we get answer square root of 1 plus I, 10 minus 2, that is 8, 8 by 2, sorry, here value of x is equal to minus 8, so positive 8, so 10 plus 8, that is 18. 18 by 2, that is square root of 9. So square root of 1 is equal to 1 plus square root of 9 is equal to 3. So square root of delta is equal to 1 plus I 3. Now we define the roots. Roots of equation, solve the quadratic equation. Solution is z is equal to minus b plus or minus root delta by 2a. So what is b? B is equal to minus 5 plus I. So minus into minus 5 plus I plus or minus. We find the value of root delta is equal to 1 plus I3 by 2a, but value of a is equal to 1, that is 2. Minus minus plus 5 plus I plus or minus 1 plus I3 by 2. One time take addition, that is first root is z1 is equal to 5 plus I plus 1 plus 3i by 2. Second time take subtraction, z2 is equal to 5 plus I minus 1 plus I3 by 2. Now remove the bracket. 5 plus I plus 1 plus 3i by 2, that is z1 is equal to, we have to take the real part of addition, 5 plus 1 is 6, imaginary part addition here is I plus 3i, that is 4i by 2. So one root we get z1 is equal to 3 plus 2i. Z2 is equal to 5 plus I minus 1 minus 3i by 2. We have to take real part combined, 5 minus 1, that is 4, imaginary part combined, I minus 3i, that is minus 2i by 2. Here taking common out 2. 2 minus 2i by 2. 2 to cancel and get other root z2 is equal to 2 minus I. So our required solution is z1 is equal to 3 plus 2i, z2 is equal to 2 minus I. So our given equation is quadratic form. So quadratic equation have z power is 2. So in this answer we get two roots z1 and z2.